I'm at least back reporting.
And outside of it.
A couple of boxing questions and I'm done. You were just in Omaha, Nebraska. You saw Terrence Crawford. We all heard Teddy Atlas' pound-for-pound list. What's your top 5 pound for pound? Ooh. Is it similar? Is it different?
You know what? I'll give you my, let's see. So number one, I still have Andre Ward. I mean, I think in terms of what he's done, it's amazing. People forget the Super 6 run that he had. Then he kind of had a lull. But, you know, if we're going by pedigree, gold medal, and what he's
beat
done.
Kovalev.
And who he's beaten. The first Kovalev fight, I saw Kovalev win by a point. But then he comes back and wins in definitive fashion. Second, I have Terrence Crawford now, because when you look at a man who does what hasn't been done since Bernard Hopkins did it against Oscar De La Hoya with a brutal body shot just like he did it, you know, Terrence Crawford has to jump up. Now, Triple G, I had him number two. I dropped him to number three, seeing what's going to happen against Canelo Alvarez. He very well could jump up to number two, depending on what happens September 16th. Then I still have Chocolatito Gonzalez. I mean, the loss to Rungmansai, I saw him win that fight.
Me too.
So at the end, he could very well be number one, but the record states different. So I'm going to drop him to number four, and I'm going to have Vasyl Lomachenko probably come in at number five. You know, I love Lomachenko. I love what he does in the ring. But, you know, the same thing that, you know, people argue about Gennady Golovkin, quality of opposition, you could say the same thing for, you know, Lomachenko. And plus the fact he's just got 10 fights. I mean, it hasn't really been proven, but the talent is there. And just based on pure talent, you got to give him that. I'll give Canelo number six. And from there on, it's all, you know, it's six and on down. There's a lot of debatable fighters.
Last two questions. You mentioned Lomachenko. You're obviously with ESPN. Now there's boxing on ESPN, Lomachenko fights on ESPN. They're talking about December 9th for him against Rigondeaux. Break it down. Two-time gold medalist versus two-time gold medalist. Two fighters who do not like each other. They talk smack online 24/7. Lomachenko told me it's personal. I'm going to beat the crap out of him.
No, Rigondeaux is one of the toughest. Actually, he is the toughest fighter to hit, followed by Vasyl Lomachenko. So you're talking about two defensive geniuses. The big difference here is Lomachenko can crack. He's got an offense to go with that defense. Not to say that Guillermo Rigondeaux doesn't, but he's just more of an Ivan Calderon type fighter. You know, I called a lot of Ivan Calderon's early fights, 105 pounds, and he used to put all his opponents down, but never finish them. Rigondeaux's the same way. I mean, he has the capability to catch you on a counter, boom, put you down, and he won't follow you. So I think Lomachenko is the opposite. If he sees you hurt, he becomes a shark in the water. He goes from offense to defense seamlessly. And I think Rigondeaux has a bigger problem doing that. He'd rather outbox you, outpoint you all night. So defensively, it's going to be a battle of geniuses. Offensively, and the fact that Rigondeaux would have to come up to 130 pounds, I would give the edge to Vasyl Lomachenko. But it has the potential to be a great fight. But it also has the potential to be a chess match, a very technical fight that won't capture the imagination of the, you know, general boxing fan. And boxing fans will be like, that was amazing. It'll be like, Strasburg against Kershaw, you know, a pitching duel where you're like, wow, these guys are going to no-nos into the eighth inning. That could happen, but fans are really not into that. Fans are into knockouts.
So there you have it, another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Sekpak reporting, and you can follow me on Twitter at Sekpak, and you can follow me on Instagram at Ellie Sekpak.